So we are giving les petits déjeuners sous les herbes a run for its money. If my nomadic ass could have seen this, like this lifestyle, me resting, journaling, taking my leisurely ass time. Like, I haven't even done 2 pages. I've done 1 page and I've kind of been slacking because it's like, I feel like I'm putting so much more, gotta check, so much more energy and attention than I would into actual forward progress, that like writing a full page in my gigantic journal can actually feel like a lot of work, because I guess now I'm getting to the good stuff, the gooey stuff that's like kind of sticky, and that's where I want to be with the sticky shit, because it's like, if I get it out, then I can get it down. Like, I get it onto paper, then it's there and it lives there until I decide to move it into another form. But I'm giving myself a tea party. The girls are inside watching like some show that was for 12 years old and up, but I'm like, yeah, they have guns, but like, we have a lot of big issues with AI. They may as well just see the present state of things. But also, why are 12 year olds seeing content with guns? I mean, regardless, le petit déjeuner sous les herbes is such a lifestyle. I'm here for it. I never do this. I never come outside with my yoga mat and just exist on the earth. But it's so beautiful. Like, this life, this home. Like, seriously, I lived out of suitcases for far too long to not just revel on this glorious Wednesday. I'm chilling, listening to Back to Marco's project that he has, like, a whole bunch of file names. And wow, it's nice. I'm digging it. There's been a few times where I'm like ad-libbing, and maybe, you know, that's something that down the line will happen for real. Like, I met Mac DeMarco at a Grill and Chill in Brooklyn, and he doesn't smoke cigarettes anymore, and I don't eat hot dogs anymore. So it's like the world has shifted for real. Like, whatever millimeters of degrees you want to measure it by, the world has absolutely changed, because I don't eat hot dogs anymore. I don't eat pork. I don't eat beef. I ate a tofu dog. I'm sure that they had that. They had to have. It was Bushwick. Like, but in case if they didn't, now, in the coming years, when Mac DeMarco and I link for music, it will be over a tofu dog and a cup of tea, likely, which I'm looking forward to. I'm feeling that.
My first memory of doing any sort of like healing work was with a xylophone. And as a kid, I used to give my dad massages. Like, I wouldn't walk on his back. I think we did walk on his back, but like, I would actually be learning like anatomy. And honestly, this past Christmas was the best Christmas ever. We had the girls with us since Christmas Eve, and I'm the kind of like stepmom who's like, please make a mess, but clean it up. Let's make crafts. Let's make a whole bunch of things and enjoy your childhood and get creative. We're at the dentist's office. Say hey.
Hello.
Where are we? We're on the beach now.
Hi.
We've been at the dentist's office for at least like 2 hours. The view of Piao Valley is so iconic. Like, I might have to come here and paint sometime. It's beautiful. I have on my painter's hat, and we're gonna go. Do you guys wanna go to the cat cafe? Okay. I already kind of don't wanna be at the mall, but they stayed at the dentist's office for as long as they did and didn't complain. I mean, Mira kind of was ready to go and got antsy, but luckily I had my AirPods. You have big teeth. Moana got some nice covers for her teeth, and this is a cute store. I've never seen it. Linda appointment only. Cool. Yeah. Oh no. No, we're going to the Cat Cafe. Cat Cafe. No, we're not going in there.
Yeah, boundaries have been a real learning curve. Like, I was a teacher at a school for a while before I met my family, my stepdaughters and my husband. And honestly, it feels like I'm giving them a wholesome experience as much as I can by, like, being an artist, by sort of not really, like, defying the odds, but just setting my visions high for myself and making sure that I attain my goals. Hello, good morning. I am journaling before I have a yoga class. I was taking my morning nice and slow. I woke up really early, but sat down to journal. My massage chair went rogue, which was kind of scary. It was like squeezing my ankles, and I was like, this kind of hurts. And then I saw I was just stuck on a setting. But I got through that. It's Friday, and I feel really good. After our Oahu trip, I realized I have to attend classes in person at least a couple times a week just to balance out my usual hermit hobbit tendencies to just hole in the house and make art out of that. I feel that last night, due to the fact that I sat and edited for like close to 4 hours, and I would, the old story, old me would just do that again today, but I know that if I'm gonna be building anything sustainable for the long run, I'm going to need breaks. And this is new for me and I love it. So I'm gonna finish journaling and I feel so good. I'm really happy. So if you haven't met me in real life, just know I am an astrology fanatic. I'm an astrologer. I've been studying astrology since I was like 14 years old. And yoga also. I've been practicing with like DVDs for the most part, and I have major hermit energy. Like, so does my husband, so we're like the perfect match. And I feel that despite being an astrology buff and fanatic, I'm always a student. I'm a student forever. I've given readings. Yes, you can reach out to me if you'd like reading. But it's not like my main practice. I feel like in my past life, I studied Vedic astrology. And in this life, I'm all about tropical astrology. I live on the Tropic of Cancer anyways. So, I think that the How I Wave project, I actually entered into a Sony Filmmakers competition, which it's like my dreams are coming full circle. I've slowed down enough. I've focused on attracting rather than chasing, which is very hard for me. I have major like masculine energy. I'm used to like waking up at the crack of dawn, working hours and hours, feeling like major frustration and, you know, sort of living in that energy. And I feel that marriage has softened me. Maui has softened me. Like, I lived in Brooklyn for 6 years and 10 months, and the last of it was this chaotic whirlwind that totally stripped me of everything I thought I knew. It made me lean into more of my spiritual practice, and that only has expanded since I got to Maui. And now I'm at a point where I feel really good slowing down, taking up space, asking for what I need, making art that matters to me. So, like, you know, I am in a year-long mentorship intensive, and I actually got to switch mentors because I have such delicate energy now that I'm like, I have to protect myself against people who would body slam me, you know, verbally. And when I spoke to the main facilitator of this program, I let her know, like, that was attractive to me at one point. I actually really enjoyed, you know, a sassy comeback. I enjoyed someone who knew exactly how to get a point across. But now, after doing the artist way, literally for almost 6 months now, I've come into this very tender place within myself, within my heart. And, you know, I've always carried like pocket crystals. I've always kind of practiced affirmations. And I feel that in the last few years of my life, I've stepped it up, and it's just given me the ability to start doing singing bowls and sound baths. And that has been sort of my foothold into making music and circling back on my dreams of making music videos and short films. And I feel a lot of gratitude for this moment, and I feel that my cycles are just spiraling upwards. And, you know, slow growth, consistent growth is where I'm headed now. And I used to be all about instant results, but now I understand that everything in nature has a season, a cycle, and once, you know, we really drop out of the sense of like rapid everything, the turbulence can kind of go away. And I know I need that to create from the place that I'm now
wanting to create from rather than my like survival instinct. It's now about what I'd like to leave behind, what I'd like to contribute to society, and I love it. So I woke up really gung-ho, knowing that I was gonna film my sound bath this morning for Sunday. And honestly, I had to work through a lot of this energy of like, it's not gonna get done. And if we don't do it, we'll fail. But last night I asked for a sign that I am working with Archangel Metatron. And like, there's a rainbow right now, but like I've recorded several rainbows and I'm gonna add it to the video in between each like sound bath sequence to reset my listeners. And then I was able to be like, okay, well, Misha even looked at the weather and he's like, it's not gonna clear up till like 9:30, and I was ready at like 8. So I was like, okay, I have some chores I can do. I guess I can eat breakfast. I guess everything's set up for the sound check. Like, it just kind of was dawning on me that no, I don't have to force and rush and like muscle everything. I could save the muscling for the pull. I don't have to muscle through these other spiritual offerings that I do. So, my breakfast toast. Now you can see it. It's amazing. Like, this is actually what I asked for. Yeah, it caused me a lot of anxiety because I'm like, why can't I just get started and make the thing? But I understand that, like, even into the future, as I'm performing, like, bigger shows, there will be bigger problems because people will have paid versus my free offering that I'm gifting to people who watch me on YouTube, which is amazing. It's how I'm getting started. It's actually how I'm really feeling the energy of music and healing my hormonal system and all of that. So I'm gonna eat my yogurt parfait. I am plant-based, so those eggs were not actual eggs. They were just egg. And sun's out, fun's out. Hey, let's go. I'm so happy because I was really like, I found myself like cramped. And then I was like, oh, wait, that's like the whole point of the sun bath is to help people through these emotions. And sometimes like, as a very receptive energy, I can pick up on them when really it's meant to be like, just notice. And that's what we're doing with the sun bath. So. So it's late. It's about 1 a.m., but I'm honoring the fact that I was so inspired that I finished editing my video. I figured out how to get a canvas up on Spotify, and like, mind you, this is just me going at it, giving it my best, as I've been doing the artist point now for like a hot minute. So, like, I literally am on round 2 of it, and I'm gonna do a third round with my friend. So, I'm honoring the late night because I'm not in the mood to just be in bed by 8:30, even though I would have loved that. Today was definitely a breakthrough, and I'm just gonna make sure that my dancers, my friends, like the edit, because honestly, it's a little, like, spicy. But we love that. We love the spice. We're here for the spice. So we are in the full swing of things here for Christmas, and it's a gorgeous day. Last night I was up until about 1:11. Literally, I checked the time, and I was editing my video, and I sent it to the girls just to get their, like, okay. And this time I didn't sign a waiver, but I feel like I have to because I'm gonna sell some merchandise, which will ultimately fund more projects. But yeah, I made some beautiful pesto toast with mac nut. This is all vegan, plant-based. I feel so grateful. This is like the best Christmas gift ever. And one of my friends, she gave me like a plant that she clipped from a waterfall, and it's currently on our waterfall that does have chlorine inside. But it looks happy to be outside. It looks like it's sprouting.
I just put it in a plastic bottle and like stuck it between rocks. So it's thriving, getting some real sunshine. It was kind of molding inside, a little too sunny and humid, like these are the plants. So I hope your holidays are going brightly and beautifully. And yeah, I feel really good moving through a lot. And I'm getting to the other side of a lot of emotions that have held me up for far too long.